Till now, we have seen the forward difference and the backward difference. So these two we have already seen. Along with them, we have also seen what the symbolic relationship, interpolation with equilibriums. Now we are going to see the central difference. In the central difference, similar to the forward and the backward difference, the data sets will be given to you. A set of data sets. X1, X2, X3, and they are corresponding Y0, Y1, Y2, these things will be given to you. Now, this is also an equidistant interpolation. So, the difference between X0 and X1, between X1 and X2, between X2 and X3, this H, it is same for all of them. You are asked to find out Xi for any value. Now, this value, suppose I've asked you to find out y of 2. Now if this 2 is in between this data set, in that case it is preferable to use the central difference. As for example, suppose in this numerical I have 4 data sets, 20 30 40 50, and I am asking you to find out 35. Now this 35 is in between this data set, isn't it? You see, it is in between the data set. So for such kind of numerical, central difference is preferable. Now there is no hard and fast rule. You can use any one forward, backward, central to find out the answer. But in the examination, if it specifically mentions you, in that case, we will be using that one. Now, unlike the forward and the backward difference, where the first one we selected to be 0, then it is 1, then it is 2, going this way. In central difference, what we do is that we take the midpoint as the x0 value. We take the midpoint as the x0 value, and on the left hand side we select them as minus 1, minus 2. On the right hand side we take it to be 1 and 2. The formula to find out y of x for central difference is this, is y0. P del y1 plus del y1, and in this way we will find out. This formula you have to remember. So this is important formula. To be honest, in respect to forward and the backward difference, the formula for the central difference is a little tough to remember, but then also if you practice regularly, then it should not be a problem. So P is your x minus x naught by a. These are same, similar to a forward and backward difference. Now you have to create the central difference table just like the forward and the backward difference. As I have told you, in the central difference table, the mid one you have to select as y0. And the corresponding things are as you have done in the forward difference, isn't it? What is del y3? This is basically this one minus this one. What is this? This is this one minus this. What is this? This is this one minus this. So these are just, this table is just like the forward difference table. The only thing is that in the central difference you have to select the midpoint as your y0 and x1. Unlike the forward and the backward, where we select this as that. That's the only difference. Let's see an example. This is an example where we have a 4 data sets of x as 20, 30, 40, 50. And corresponding values are this. Now you have been asked to find out y35. What is the value of y35? Now this y35 is in between 30 and 40. We can select any one of them as our x0. We can select either 30 as x0 or 40 as x0. For this example, I am selecting 40 as my x0. So if 40 is as my x0, so as you can see in the table, this is my x0. 40 is my x0. Corresponding to 40, this is my y0. Then this will be minus x minus 1, this is x minus 2, and this is x plus 1. Now we have created the forward difference table. So in order to calculate del y minus 2, what we did, we subtracted this minus this, as you can see. Similarly, for me. Again, we have del square y, we have done what? Minus 93 minus minus of 73. So we got this. For del square y minus 1, we have minus 103 minus minus of 23. So we have created a central resource formula. What is our x? X is what you are asked to find out. In this example, it is 35. What is your x naught? X naught is what you have selected. You are selecting this. I am selecting x naught as 40. What is my age? What is the difference between them? 20, 30, 40, 50. What is the difference between them? It is 10. So, this age. So then I know what is my p. So my p is 10. As you can see, the as per the formula. See, in this particular formula, how many variables, how many points you should consider? So it depends upon what are the values you already have. See, this y naught, you have this value. This del y minus 1, you have this value. Del y minus 1, you have the value. Del y, you have this value. Del square y minus 1, del square y minus 1, you have this value. After that, this del cube y minus 2, you have this value. Del cube y minus 2, as you can see, del 2 y minus del cube y minus 2, you have this value. But what about del cube y minus 1? Do you have any such value over here? Del cube y minus 1, do you have this value? No. Since you don't have this value, so you are not going to consider this. So I am only taking the first three terms because I do not have the value for this. So once you have the formula, just replace y naught. What is your y naught? This is your y naught. Qp you have already calculated. Del y naught, del y minus 1 you already know. And then this del square y minus 1 you already know. So just put down the values and you can easily calculate your y. So this is the central difference. I am repeating once more. Another until it is said in the question, central difference. It's preferable that you use forward and backward because they are easier to do. But if your data set is in between, if the value we were asked to find out is in between the data sets, then central difference is required. Now with this, we have done with our equal intervals. So this equal intervals part has been done. This forward difference, backward difference, central difference, these were for equal intervals. So we have completed this. Now let's see what about unequal. What about unequal intervals? Now for them we have two formulas. One is the Lagrange's and another is the Newton's dividend difference formula. So let's start with the Lagrange's formula. In the Lagrange's formula, what happens is that you have, depending upon your data sets, you are using the formula. As you can see over here, I have five data sets, x0, x1, x2, x3 and x4, and corresponding to the individual x we have y0, y1, y2, y3 and y4. Now if this is my data set, then the formula that we are going to write uses this, 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1. Now let me, you don't have to remember this formula, just try to understand the formula, then it will be easier for you. Since there are 5 data sets, so you are using 5 y's. So y not 1, y 1, y 2, y 3 and y 4. So there are 5 y's. Now since in this, in the first term, I have my y not, so I am not going to use x not in this term. In the numerator, I am not going to use x not. See, there is no x not. Similarly, as there is y not over here, I am going to start it with naught, and there will be no more x1 over here. Similarly, as you can see, this is y1. Since this is y1, you will not find any x1 in the numerator. In the denominator, this terms will be x1, but there is no x1. See, here is x1, but here you will not find the denominator. You will find x1. Again, since I have y2 over here, in the numerator, you will not find x2, but in the denominator this will start with x2. Similarly, by y3 over here, there is no x3 in the numerator, but it starts with x3 in the denominator. obviously you're not going to do x3 minus x3 over here, or it will become infinity, isn't it? So that is a common sense too. Again, you have y4 over here. So there are no y4 in the numerator, and it starts with y4. Now, if I have y5, is there, since I have been given one more data set, I have x5 corresponding to y5. In that case, in the numerator, you will not find any x of 5, you will not find any x in the numerator, and the denominator will start with this x of 5. Now, this inverse, this Lagrange's formula, it can also be used as an inverse Lagrange's formula. What I mean by that is that in this particular numerical, for x you are finding y. For all x you have been given a y, and for you in the answer also you will be asked for a particular x, you will be asked to find out y. But you can do the opposite also. The opposite is that you will be given y and you will be asked to find out x. You will find the answer for x. In that case, what happens is that the formula, the pattern remains the same. The only thing that changes is that in place of y naught, you are not going to write x naught. And in place of all the x's, you replace them with y. That's it. It's the only thing that will change. That's really the case. So this Lagrange's method, which is for unequal interval, this can be used for inverse Lagrange's also. Now let's take an example and see how it works out. We have a data set, x's 5, 7, 11, 13, 17. As you can see, h is not equal. H is different. Over here it is 2, over here it is 4, over here it is 2, over here it is 4. So these are not equal. And hence, I cannot use the Newton forward, backward, or etc. I have to use either the Lagrange's or the Newton linear difference. Here I am discussing the Lagrange's first. So for x naught, you have a y naught. You have been given, see, this is my x naught, this is my y naught, this is my x1, this is my y1. x3, y3, x4, y4, x5, y5. So x0, x1, x2, x3, x4. So x4, y4. What we are asked to find out? We are asked to find out f of 9. We are asked to find out f of 9. How to do so? You have the formula, isn't it? How many data sets are there? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Since there are 5 data sets, as you can see, here also I have 5 data sets. So this is the formula that I am going to use. I'm going to directly write this entire thing over here. See, since I have y naught over here, there is no x naught in the numerator, but in the denominator, all the starts with x naught. I have y1 over here, there is no y1 in the numerator, sorry, x1 in the numerator, but it starts with x naught. Now, all once you have written the formulas, just replace the values which is present here: x naught, x1, x2, x3, x4, y0, y1, also. For your simplicity, I have mentioned some of this x. What is this x which you need to find out, which is 9? What is your x1? See, x1 is your 7, so I have written 7 over here. So, for your simplicity, I have written the numbers with that pen. I will highly encourage you to do it on your copy. Just, I will provide you with a PDF. Just note of the PDF and do it in your copy. Now, just place the values. At the end, you will find out x, y, 9 is 110. Sorry, 810. So do it and see if it matches or not. If you face any problem, you can WhatsApp me. Now, the next difference formula, unequal interpolation for unequal differences is Newton-Dividend difference interpolation formula. Here also, as I have told you, the data says they will not, range will not be equal. Now, over here, what you need to do is that you need to find del of y naught. But see, this del of y naught is a little different. This del of y naught, they have this term. So this kind of symbol is there. So this symbol is there. You can go, you can see how I have written them. What is del of y naught is y1 minus y naught by x1 minus x2. So you can see that. But let me show you with an example that it will be preferable to understand it clearly. See, I have a data sets. I have data sets of 4. These are the 4 data sets. In the corresponding y's are present. As you can see, this h is not equal, so I will either use the Lagrange's formula or the Newton-Dividend formula. You have been asked to find out for f is equals to 4 and f dash 4. Now, how to do so? See, the formula to calculate this is this. This is the formula. as you can see, this is the formula. So in this particular formula, you need y naught, which will be given to you. X is what you need to find out, y naught. This del y naught, this del square y naught, this is the value which you need to calculate from the table, which you are from this table. So how to do so? It's very easy. The formula for del y naught is y1 minus y naught by x1 minus x naught. Del y1 is y2 minus y1. So it's 1. So it starts with y2, y1, x2 minus x1. See, y del y2 is x3. If it is 2, it is 3. And it is 2. Similar del square y1. What is del square y1? It is del of y1 minus del of y0 by x2 minus x1. Del square y2 is del of y2 minus del y1 by x3 minus x1. What is del cube y0? It is del square y1 minus del square y0 by x3 minus x1. So this is the same thing. Let's see the example. I have 4 data sets. I have written the 4 data sets. X0, y0, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. What is del of y0? What is del of y0? Del of y0 is this term minus this term divided by this term minus this term. As you can see. Again, what is del of y1? Is this term minus this term divided by this term minus this term. As you can see. Again, what is del y2? It is this term minus this term and divided by this term minus this term. So you have your del y. Next, you need to find del square y. What is del square y now? It is this term minus this term divided by this. And what is del square y1? It is this term minus this term divided by this. And del cube y0 is this. So now I have my del of y0, I have my del square y0, I have del cube y0, I have this value. So see, since I have this value, I can directly replace them over here. I do not have any del to the power 4 y0, I don't need it as part of this question. This x, it is what? This x is what you are asked to find out. In my case, it is 4. This y0, obviously you have from the table, it is y0. And this x0, x1, x2, these values are already given to you. So just write the formula, replace the values, you will find your equation, which is your f of x. Since you know f of x, then you can find out what is f of 4, just replace x with 4. If you need to find out f dash x, what is f dash x of this? It is minus 2x plus 13. So these are the two methods by which you can find out for unequal intervals. And then we have seen interpolation of power difference, also we have done Newton's formula, Lagrange. This thing has been completed. The next we will see is Gauss formula for interpolation result. So, interpolation with unequal intervals we have completed. This is the only term which is left. Thank you.